Can I help you?
Oh, hi there. Yeah, I was just reading some stuff up on the internet here about the NSA and what you guys do and all that. And so I spoke to a lady earlier, and she said that all that stuff that's in the press and stuff is just not true. Like, you guys
Much
don't.
of it is much of it is not true.
Much
What
of it
they
is
do,
not true.
they started with they start with either half truths or assumptions and so forth, and they build on that instead of building on the facts. And so a lot of the stuff at this point, what you get is, it's hard to distinguish truth and fiction in a lot of the
Oh
stuff you're
yeah,
reading.
sure is. None of like all this stuff with your partners there. Now she mentioned y'all's partners, I guess, which would be Facebook and MySpace and Yahoo Plus and all that. Are y'all partners with them in any way, shape, or form? Is that
Well,
true?
we can't really talk about outside folks that we would or wouldn't work with.
Ah, okay.
We unfortunately, can't publicly talk about that kind of stuff, whether
Yeah.
we do or don't, But the thing is, though, a lot of the stuff again that you're reading there is again, when it all started, it just, based on what somebody was saying and didn't have all the facts, and then when you build on something like that, just like a house, you build a house and it has a weak foundation, it's going to fall down,
Yeah.
and that's basically what's happened, and unfortunately, people out there are thinking, NSA is listening to all their phone calls and so forth. Absolutely not true. Absolutely
Well,
not true. I mean,
that's precisely why I'm calling you. You get information from the press, and you can't necessarily trust that they've, do the most utmost integrity to keep all their facts straight and stuff like that. That's why I call. But then I find it kind of. I mean, it's like you say, you're not allowed to even discuss this stuff. So it's kind of with your partners. So it's kind of, it almost
I
like
understand.
yeah. So you have to, I guess you guys have to maintain a sort of a veil of secrecy to some extent, right?
Unfortunately, you do. I mean,
Yeah.
unfortunately, you do. The thing is this,
So that, I mean, kind of just to boil it down, the Al Qaeda doesn't get us and stuff, right?
That's true. I mean, you don't
Yeah.
want the enemy to find out
But can I
how you do
ask,
what you do.
did you know that who our biggest enemy was back in the 50s and 60s and up into the 80s? That
Well,
we had to worry about we, that our biggest enemy that we were United States was highly concerned about. Do you know who that was?
who was that?
The
Oh, you're asking me
Soviets.
or me?
Yeah, just as a sort of
Well, I
history
mean,
quiz.
just speaking for myself, I would say probably the Soviet Union.
Yeah. You know that we were supplying them with grain that whole time, and so was Canada.
Oh yeah, I learned that in school.
Yeah. So what do you think was up with that?
I don't know. It just I don't know the decisions made behind everything. I'm sure economics
Sure,
plays a
yeah,
lot
but I
part of
mean,
it,
you wanna like feed and support your enemy, and then you can like
and yeah,
you can
that's the
like hang
discussions.
people. You can hang
Yeah,
people
they're
for
the discussions
treason.
we had in school. Just like today.
Yeah.
Like there's you read in the press about China and all this, and then
Yeah,
go to
but
the
then
store, most of the stuff you buy, where's it made,
yeah, exactly. You got it, man. So
Excuse me.
they can hang you, they can hang me. I mean, figuratively speaking, for treason, which is by definition giving aid and comfort to the enemy. And we're supplying. I mean, under the rug, supplying grain to the Soviet Union. So what are we talking about here, man? I mean, now we got this going on, and there's been some stuff that's come out that's kind of. Talking about the PRISM program, how this collecting, how they're, the NSA is getting data from the, and that's kind of, it seems like to me that's possibly what's going on is it kind of gives you guys sort of a plausible deniability so that you can emphatically state, oh, we don't collect data on American citizens. No. But yeah, our partners, what you guys don't tell is that your partners do. and you work with your partners, and then you can you know, you have also your foreign stations, which are, for what I understand, there's a pretty big hub in Canada that you guys can back so that they can spy on Americans, and
you know,
then you can,
sir,
transfer with them.
We cannot ask another country to do something we are not legally allowed to ourselves, and we don't set up partnerships to make that happen.
But they just kind of, you don't have to ask them, I guess. They kind of just do it on their own volition and then kind of coordinate with you guys. Is that how it works?
Not to my knowledge. Not to my knowledge. If we legally cannot do these things that we're saying we can't do, that's in the media, we can't go to Canada or anybody else and say, can you do it for us, or be in a position where...
Well, let's just say hypothetically that they said, "Hey, we got all this data. You guys want it, but you know, you can't ask for it. But could you just go ahead and accept their
generous
offer?"
Well, that would be to that country, you know, whatever.
Sure.
You know,
yeah.
I mean, if it's illegal in that country, usually it is. Then that would be illegal. Also, we couldn't do that.
If it was illegal, yeah, I get you. I get you. Yeah, I got you. Yeah. So yeah, it's kind of a little bit of a... It's not too cut and dry. It's a little bit, I get you. I understand. I totally understand. So, like,
I'm looking for that would help you. I'm looking for to see if I can find a link here. There was a talk that General Alexander gave a couple weeks ago, and if you were to be able to read that, I mean, he hits it right on the head, answering most of these, if not all of these, issues that you're raising.
Yeah. Can I speak to him?
Oh, no, I mean, we can't afford from here.
He keeps his information kind of private, huh? You can't really get all his information, can you?
Well, you can imagine, being a four-star general, I mean,
yeah,
he's, number of queries come in all day, every day.
Yeah, he's got to keep his information private. Yeah, I understand that. We all like our privacy, don't we?
We do. I know I do. Everybody does.
I do. And you guys don't really want to talk too much about, you kind of like, you, but you seem like, you're kind of private people over there at the NSA yourselves. So that's, I guess, you know, that's fair. I mean, that's fair if you're not collecting data on the average person, but I seem like it would be kind of a little bit hypocritical if you guys were, and then kind of like want to kind of keep your own little powwow over there kind of secret. You know what I mean? That's kind of distasteful, and it seems. I mean, you would kind of understand why people would be suspicious of you. You know what I mean?
Yeah, it's understandable, but unfortunately, I mean, as I said, a lot of this stuff, most of it, it's just not true. I'm looking for a fact sheet that might help you out and understand exactly what the facts are, and then build on that. And then it's just that, you know, as far as, you know, collecting everybody's, you know, listening in on phone calls and emails, it's really absurd. It's illegal. It's absurd.
Yeah, what would
and
you do with
we
it
just
anyway?
Don't do that.
Pardon? Like, what would you do with, like, massive
exactly,
amounts of phone
exactly.
calls?
Exactly, it'd be humanly impossible
have
to deal with it.
Have you heard of sentient world simulation?
I'm sorry?
Have you heard of the sentient world simulation? The
no.
SWS program the military is operating? Yeah,
no,
so
no,
what
no.
it does, it takes mass, you know, if you wanted to kind of, like, think of maybe a conspiracy theory or something, this sounds pretty far-fetched, but... you know, if you were to imagine some use for all this data, like you can port it into some, big number cruncher supercomputer and kind of get detailed psychological profiles on everyone based on their searches and their behavior online and stuff like that. And then you could, like, for instance, like one possible application would be you could create more efficient propaganda or different scenarios and stuff for controlling and managing large populations. I mean, that's just hypothetical, I guess, but I mean, I don't know. Like, what else? You know, I mean, the fact is, though, I mean, I think the facts are out there that this data is being collected somewhere. I mean, Echelon, I mean, it's been kind of publicly admitted that they aggregate, like, every single phone call and every single email on the planet. So, and, you know, if that's not the case, why would you need massive, you know, servers and all that? and supercomputers, you wouldn't really need all those if you ain't saving nothing, would you?
Yeah, I mean, as the generalists have said, what's collected is called metadata,
Yeah.
and
Metadata
that's
is kind
it,
of like data on
numbers.
data. It's not the calls or
And
nothing
it's all
itself.
foreign. It's all foreign focused. It's nothing. It's all foreign
So
focused.
y'all
Anyway, so
really.
I really have to run here, though,
Oh,
sir.
one more question. Like
Yeah.
about y'all's hardware and stuff. So y'all really kind of like are kind of over prepared because since you only save metadata, which is data on data, you would only need like a very minuscule amount, relatively speaking, data
I
storage
don't know.
capacity. But you guys got some pretty heavy duty hardware. So like, what do you guys do with all that? Can you answer that?
Mean, I couldn't answer. I mean,
Secret, huh?
I'm
Private.
not. Pardon me?
That's private information, huh?
I
Sure,
couldn't
sure, sure.
answer
Yeah,
what we do.
it's private. That's okay. It's private. I understand. You guys like your privacy. I understand that. That's perfectly understandable. You're a human being and you enjoy your privacy, so that's good with me. Okay. All right, thanks a lot, man.
All
You
right,
have a
thanks
good
for
one.
calling. Have a good day. Bye-bye.
Okay, take care.